Thanks, Don, for the intro. Well, it's great to be here at PegaWorld, and I have to give a special shout-out to Pega for doing this event in a virtual fashion, allowing us to continue to collaborate and learn from each other. Well, as introduced, my name is Rich Gilbert, and I'm the Chief Digital and Information Officer at Aflac. And I'm coming to you from my home here in Columbus, Georgia. Well, I know when you think about Aflac, I know what you think about. You think about the Aflac duck. Now, this has been our brand icon and our recognition for the last 20 years, and this duck has helped us become well known. So I wanted to start with a little bit about Aflac. So Aflac was founded in 1955 by three brothers as a cancer insurance company. And since then, we've grown. We've grown to $26 billion. We have over 50 million customers worldwide, and we operate predominantly in the US and Japan. We specialize in supplemental benefits, and those are things like accident insurance, cancer insurance, critical illness, and even life insurance. And with the COVID situation, Aflac provides policyholders the ability to bridge the gap for unexpected costs that medical insurance doesn't cover. And our products provide people with the peace of mind knowing that Aflac is there in their time of need to be able to focus on recovery instead of financial stress. So with a little bit about Aflac, let's dive into our digital transformation. So after 65 years in the insurance industry, we've had to reinvent. And the digital era has required us to reinvent the way we engage with our customers, our policyholders, our agents, and our brokers. And we're looking ahead to transform and invent ourselves in the industry by launching new products and leveraging new technologies. So earlier today, you heard Alan talk about three things. He talked about customer centricity. He talked about operating as a service and creating a platform for your platforms. Today, I want to share what we've been able to do through all of those things through our digital transformation. We've launched a new vision called One Digital Aflac, which is really focused on the customer. We built a new operating model that we focus on providing services for our organization. And third, we've replaced many of our legacy core technologies with new technologies and new platforms. So I'll start by giving you a little bit of an evolution of our transformation. So I'm going to take you back to 2014. So in 2014, we started our digital transformation, or really our transformation at the time, and it was focused on technology for technology's sake. Things like data center optimization and implementing service buses. We were building the first data warehouses, and we were doing things like ripping and replacing policy admin systems. So fast forward to today, and in 2020, the digital model has shifted. It's no longer about working on technology-centric things. It's all around focusing on customer-centric things. And we had to rethink our customer expectations around things like ease, around value, around service, and what does digital mean relative to those expectations? So I know digital means a lot of things to a lot of people. And when I think about digital, I think about my cell phone. And this device has helped me transact and do things easier. And as a customer, it's changed the way I expect companies to engage with me. So we realized that digital at its core is all around using technology to make things easier. So when we launched our One Digital Aflac vision, we said, let's use that as our first tenet. Let's use technology to make things easier. Let's use technology to make it easier for our customers to be able to buy and interact with us. Let's make it easier for our sales teams to sell in the marketplace and run successful businesses. Let's make it easier for our employees who work at Aflac to do what they do every day. And overall, making it easier for us to fulfill our promise. So that was the first tenet behind One Digital Aflac, using technology to make things easier. The second around One Digital Aflac is a focus on customer centricity. Now, you heard Alan talk about this. And in the past, like I said, we were focused on technology-centric items. And today, we've had to shift to be customer-centric. And we've looking at everything from the lens of the customer back. And we've changed our prioritization model to do just that. If it's not driving value for the customer, it doesn't get prioritized. So now I'd like to shift on how we take our One Digital Aflac from vision to reality. And the first thing we needed to do is we needed to create a new operating model that supports our strategy. If you think about it, what we're trying to do is put the customer first, drive value quickly with tangible results, and do all of that while maintaining core stability for our business. So we thought about how is the best way to organize your technology team. And we thought about that and said it all comes down to business services. And if you think about the services that make up an insurance business, we looked at what are those? And there are things like how do we enable our agents? And how do we enroll new policyholders? How do we do things like file claims and process claims? How do we facilitate billing and payments? And how do we support all of that through a contact center or call center? And with those services in mind, we redesigned our technology operating model to focus on our business services. And we call it our digital services operating model. And it's not just about IT, it's about bringing the business teams together with the technology teams. And what we've been able to do is we prioritize everything from the lens of the customer. And we've done that by taking the product owner from the business and said, you represent the customer and make sure you put the customer first in our experience. And it's really the linchpin to our customer-centric model. The second thing we've had to do in delivering our vision is being able to deliver with speed. And so we've implemented Agile, and everybody knows Agile is about taking these large programs, breaking smaller deliverables, and running into 2-week sprints where we can deliver value quickly and easily. So we put Agile as part of our delivery model. The third thing is all around changing out our fundamental technologies that make it easier for our customers to be able to interact with us and for our business to run. It's all around changing out those technology platforms that support your business. And this is where I want to shift and talk a little bit about how Pega has been a key enabler for our business strategy. So you heard Alan talk about Pega being a platform for our platform. Well, it's really done that for us. It's allowed us to rip and replace older, inefficient legacy systems and replace them with processes that are more efficient, flexible, and give us the ability to gain speed, gain quality in our operations, be able to drive insights faster, and most importantly, it's given us an improved customer experience. So as mentioned, our One Digital Aflac vision was all about using technology to make things easier. So let's look at a few use cases where we've been able to use Pega to use technology to make it easier for both our customers and our employees. We pride ourselves on two key areas. The first is paying claims timely and efficiently. The second is all around providing excellent customer service. Those are our key business drivers. And let's look at claims. So if you think about the claims experience, the customer journey all focuses on how they start to access our platform. And you know, we did an analysis and we found our customers really struggled with using our web and mobile platform in that they couldn't remember some simple things. They couldn't remember their user ID. They couldn't remember their password. They couldn't remember their policy number. Now, if you contrast that with, for example, banking, most of us check our banking app, you know, once a week, once a day. And if you're trading stocks in today's environment, you're checking, you know, 3, 4, 5 times a day. And so you're using your applications very frequently. In insurance, it's very different. You might use your log on to your mobile application 2, maybe 4 times a year. As a result, customers were trying to access our systems and they were having a hard time doing that. So with that pain point in mind, we launched our guest checkout. And we use Pega to be able to do this to revolutionize our claims process. Now policyholders don't have to know their user ID, their password, or their policy number to file a claim. When they log in and they come to our system, all they have to do is be able to provide a few pieces of information. We will take that information, correlate that with their policyholder and their policy number, and be able to file a claim on their behalf. And the guest checkout experience has transformed how we do claims processing and enhances our digital experience by 1, making it easier for our customer. 2, providing a self-service capability, which would otherwise result in a call to our call center. And 3, leverage automation to correlate customer information with our claims. With this new ability, we've now processed thousands of claims for policyholders using this guest checkout. Now, taking another step, once you've actually filed a claim, the second pain point that we know is that customers want to know, what's my claim status, right? Has it been paid or not? And what we did is we looked at the industry and we said, who does this really well? And of course, if you look at shipping companies, they track packages extremely well and tell you the location of that package throughout the entire journey. And we said, let's apply that to claims. So we simply put together a claims tracker that tracks the status to know whether it's been submitted, whether the documentation has been processed, whether the claim has been adjudicated, and whether the claim has been paid. Now, if you think about these two things, guest checkout and claim status tracker, they're not really revolutionary in the industry at large. However, when you look at applying them to insurance, they are very transformative, and they change the way the insurance team, the insurance works. Those technologies become game changers for us. And both of these improvements have been used, and we've been able to optimize our customer experience using Pega. But these things also support our internal operations. So if you think about, once we've submitted a claim using our guest checkout and having the ability to check the status, then it goes through a back-end workflow. And our back-end workflow was highly manual. It was a process that took us, you know, a while to be able to process through, and it was complicated. And what we were able to do is we used our Pega workflow engine to be able to optimize the workflow, to be able to streamline things for our employees. We've been able to optimize how a claim has been processed. We've been able to deploy automation that optimizes the whole process end to end. And doing all of that while providing improved visibility as that claim processes through that workflow. Next, I want to talk a little bit about game-changing activities around customer service. And we've used Pega to create a whole new contact center that we're calling PAVE. And PAVE stands for prioritizing, automating, valuing, and experience. And it's really, how do we transform our customer experience through a contact center? And so we took the Pega platform and our agile delivery model, and we married those together and said, let's put value into the market quickly. And the first thing we wanted to tackle is live chat. And so we were able to put together a model where in just a few simple sprints, we had chat going across one line of business. And then COVID hit, and we were able to scale chat across all of our lines of business with just in a few weeks. And so we've been able to serve our customers more effectively and efficiently. Now, we wanted to take this and continue to build on the agile model and deliver more value. So we took chat and we married it with our automation to be able to create chatbots. And we focused on our top 15 high volume requests that come into the call center. And by putting in chatbots, we were able to resolve 86% of these 15 request types with a containment rate of 61%. Now with that, I hope that provides you with some insights that demonstrate the value and potential that Pega has for your digital transformation. I've been excited about what we've been able to accomplish and our journey ahead as we leverage Pega and other digital capabilities to be able to make things easier for our customers. Now, before I leave you, I do want to talk a little bit about some of the challenges and lessons learned. You heard us talking about new technologies for our customers, our employees, and deploying new workflows. And I'll just be candid, putting in those new technologies took time and we did experience challenges. One thing I'd like to leave you with is when you do implement new platforms, take the time to do change management and training. When we first rolled out our claims workflow, it was difficult. People struggled with it and they had a hard time using it. So when we implemented new technologies, even though they were better, quicker, easier technologies, they had difficult learning those new technologies, and there was a learning curve associated with that. So one lesson is, make sure you take the time to train your new employees in the technologies. Don't assume immediate adoption, especially if you're going from a legacy platform and process to a new process. It takes time to adapt and become proficient. The second thing from a lessons learned that I wanted to mention with you is when you implement a new technology platform, you have to invest in your people. You have to invest in the technology capabilities around that. We've trained people, we've hired people. Our Aflac Northern Ireland site, we've dedicated that to Pega. We've hired 32 people. We've trained them. They've become certified in Pega. And they have been instrumental in helping us continue to build our practice. So as you think about implementing new technologies, make sure you're doing the right investments in your people as well as investing in change management. So overall, we've covered our One Digital Aflac journey, some of our use cases, some of our successes, our challenges, and how we've been able to evolve, and implement new processes that satisfy both our customers and our employees. And in closing, I'd like to give another shout out to Pega for helping us through this transformation. Pega has won our Partner of the Year award for being our best technology partner. We've had exceptional teamwork in helping us drive our overall business value. With that, Don, I appreciate the opportunity to share our story at this year's Pega Inspire event, and I'll turn it back over to you.